Hallelujah. We also want to welcome those who is watching this broadcast. We thank you so much for being with us this morning. Amen. And we pray that this service this morning will be a blessing to each of us. Hallelujah. God is good. Amen. God is good. Hallelujah. He is a good God. He is a faithful God. In Jesus' name. Amen. So He is the one who deserves all the praise and all the glory. Regardless what you see or what it looks like, He is still God. And He is above all these circumstances. Amen. So let's we open up in prayer in the name of Jesus. Heavenly Father, we thank you so much. We thank you, Father, for who you are, for everything that you have done, continue to do in each of our lives. Lord, you are faithful God. You are God who is able to do great things. And we're expecting to hear from you this morning. And Father, we lift unto you, Lord God, this service. And we pray in the name of Jesus that you will move by your Spirit in this service, that you will touch every person who is here, those who is watching this broadcast. Lord, touch your people. Let your power, let your anointing manifest in your people's lives in such a way like never been before. Lord, as Pastor Larry come and ministering to your people, we thank you, Father, that we have an understanding and revelation and knowledge through your word. And Father, that your name will be glorified through our lives in the name of Jesus. Amen. Hallelujah. That is so important in each of our lives as a believers. Everything that we do in our lives. And think about everything that you do in your life that is bring glory to God, your actions, your behaviors, how will you treat other people, how will you talk to people, what are you saying to people. And we as a people, sometimes we do make mistakes, right? But the examine our hearts is the important part. When we examine our heart, see, God is the faithful God. He is a God of mercy. He is God of love. He is a God of compassion. He is a merciful God, and He gave mercy those who choose. He choose to give mercy certain people because He is a merciful God. And He love and correct those who He love. And we as His people, when we, even some of us as a parents, natural parents, we want to correct the child, we speak to the child, and we want that child will accept this correction. Well, God is also bringing the correction in each of our lives, in each of our hearts. Because He doesn't want us to fail. He wants us to be succeed. He doesn't want us to be the puppets in Satan's hands. And He wants us that we accept correction. That we, when we speak to our kids, we want that the child will accept that correction. The same way when God speaks to us, He wants that we accept that correction. Do you remember in a book of 2 Samuel chapter 2? And it's somewhere in a verse 25, and you can check in 2 Samuel talking about chapter 2. How you remember that how Hannah gave her son, right? And Eli, you remember what happened to his sons? It's not that they just did wrong things, but they also was corrected by Eli. Eli he confronted them and he told them that what are you guys doing here? That's wrong. But do you know what Eli's sons did? They did not accept the correction. They still go forward to do what they want to do. Ungodly behaviors, wrong stuff. So when God wants to correct us and want to bring the correction, he can speak to us through his word. Sometimes he can bring the correction from certain individuals. God brought the correction from Eli. He spoke to his sons. But the sons did not receive the correction, and they got the consequences for that. God have mercy over your people. And I thank you, Father, as Pastor Larry come and ministering to us. If any of us need a corrections in some areas in our lives, that we will accept that correction, Lord. That we will go in a way that you guide us to. In a way of godliness, in a way of holiness, in a way that pleasing you, Lord God, pleasing your sight, Lord God. And Father, we're giving you a praise and glory that truly our lives bring glory to your name. In Jesus' mighty name, amen. Hallelujah. Well, God is good. We're going to worship him and we praise his holy name. And we have a minister of music here. Minister Eric, so he's gonna lead us into the praise and worship in Jesus' name. Amen.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Welcome to the Lord's house, or at least where the house of the Lord gathers in his name. Amen. Because wherever you are watching this day, you are also the house of the Lord. We are temples of the Lord. We've gathered in this place and we're going to lift up corporate praise, corporate worship. We're going to declare the works of the Lord. Sometimes we're so in a hurry to go into the Holy of Holies that we forget. But the Lord likes us to remember all the things that he's already done. We need to declare his greatness and his glory in Jesus. Oh,
Ourselves, Father, free, delivered, walking by faith and not by sight. Help us to experience the life that you have came and sent your Son to give his life for. Help us to experience the life, God, that you intend for us to live in this hour, in this day, in this time. And give us the ability, Lord God, to walk upright before you and to serve you, to lay our life down, that we may take up your life. Help us to see ourselves, Father, walking as a crucified soldier of the cross. Help us to see ourselves, Father, as you see us, walking free from the sin and the lust of this world, walking upright before you as churches of light. God, we thank you. Holy Spirit, we welcome you. We welcome you, Holy Spirit. We need you, Holy Spirit, to lead us and to guide us in all truth and to show us things to come. We can't do it in our own strength. We can't do it in our own abilities. We can't do it in our own might. We can't do it in our own knowledge. God, we need you. We need you. You created us. You created us in your image and after your likeness. And so, Father, we count on you. We trust you. We ask you, Father, in spite of everything that we experience throughout our days, Father, use us for your glory. Forgive us of all our sins and cleanse us from all unrighteousness. Let your glory fill this place. I ask this in Jesus' mighty name. Thank you for it, Father. Amen. Amen. Glory to God. To God be the glory. He's good. Amen. You may be seated in the presence of the Lord. God bless you. Welcome to New Life in Christ Jesus Church. Amen. Where Jesus Christ is glorified. Amen. Amen and amen. And I believe that we are in a good place today to hear from heaven. Amen. That we will not just hear from heaven, but we're going to trust God. We're going to trust God.
Amen. Amen. Hallelujah.
Amen.
All right.
Is that stuff still working back there? Oh, glory to God. We are in a good place right now, folks. Kind of turn me down just a little bit over there. Amen. That's better. That's better. That's better. Glory to God. Amen. Amen. And amen. Glory to his name. Yeah, that's it. We still up and running. I just had to get my monitors up. Amen. I want you to know that God is on the throne.
Amen. Yes,
he is. He's not coming down just because some devil trying to make things look rough for you. He's not going to leave his position of authority. He intends for us to begin to exercise our authority as children of the cross. Because he's given us the authority. We have to understand this authority and begin to abide by this authority. Amen. Let the word of God begin to bring forth his desire in our lives and in our hearts. Amen. So now I want you to open your Bible with me because we've been teaching on this message for some time now. Amen. I tried to get off of it, but God said no. And I understand why. I understand why. Because we still having challenges in our lives. How many are still having challenges in your life? We all are, huh? And this is why God doesn't want us to get off right now, because we all are still having challenges, and God wants us to be strengthened in these areas. And a lot of times we are still having these challenges because we have not allowed the word of God to become a living reality in our hearts. Amen. And sometimes it's not that we have not allowed the word of God to become reality in our hearts. Sometimes we just have not yielded to the reality of God's word. Amen. Because God wants us to be strong. God wants us to be men and women clothed in righteousness.
Amen.
Amen. And I know that it's not always easy. But I tell you what, it's not always hard neither. We just got to have a want to. Amen. We just got to have a want to. So with that being said, let's turn to the book of John chapter 3. John chapter 3. Amen. Y'all familiar with John chapter 3?
Yes.
I know you. Oh, glory to God. We all are, huh? Amen. We all are familiar with John chapter 3. But we're faced with some facts here that we need to address today. Amen. Let's start reading verse number 1. There was a man of the Pharisees named Nicodemus, the ruler of the Jews. The same came to Jesus by night and said unto him, Rabbi, we know that thou art a teacher, that we know thou art a teacher come from God. For no man can do the miracles that thou doest except God be with him. Now notice what he said in verse number 3. Jesus answered and said unto him, Verily, verily, I say unto thee, except a man be what?
Born
again, he cannot see the kingdom of God. Amen. And now this is something that we need to pay attention to today, because God wants us to see his glory. God wants us to see his strength. God wants us to see his power. Amen. But notice what he said, verse number 3, except a man be what? Born again. Born again. Amen. Except a man be born again, he cannot see the kingdom of God. Amen. So we want to see the kingdom of God, but yet we don't want to live the life that God has called us to live. Huh? We want to see the kingdom of God, but yet we don't want to put away our sin. We want to see the kingdom of God, but yet we still focusing on the things and doing things that is contrary to the will of God. Y'all understand what I'm saying? How do I know? Because I'm a human being too. Amen. We all make mistakes. We all do things that we have to give an account for. Amen. And so what God is showing us right here, what God is showing us, because I was looking, this is not on my notes. This is God. I'm going to let you know that right now. Because I got my notes right here. And I'm not nowhere on my notes. I was just standing right there, and God just put this right in my spirit right here. Amen. To deal with this area right here. Because you see, we have a tendency of saying, God, forgive me of my sin. Forgive me, Lord God. And I thank you that you've forgiven me. But then we go right back to doing the same thing we always did. Y'all ever did that? Now, we all have, huh? We all are guilty of it. And that's why God has given us the word as he's given us today. Notice what he said. Except a man be born again, he cannot see the kingdom of God. Cannot see the kingdom of God. We cannot see his strength. We cannot see his glory. We cannot see his anointing. We cannot see his power. Why? Because we have not yielded to him in this way. Notice what it said, verse number 4. Nicodemus said unto him, how can a man be born when he's old? Can he enter a second time to his mother's womb and be born? See, we think that it has to do with natural. This is nothing of the natural. This is all supernatural. This is by the Spirit that God is talking to us. This is not by the flesh that God is talking to us. He's talking to us by the Spirit, because it's by the Spirit that we will experience the kingdom of God. It's by the Spirit that we will enter into the kingdom of God. Not by the flesh. Amen? Not by the flesh. See, that's why he tells us in Romans chapter 8, verse number 1. There is therefore now no condemnation to them who are in Christ Jesus, who walk not after the flesh, but after the Spirit. God wants us walking after the Spirit, not after the flesh. And I know y'all look at me like, yeah, Lee, you're the one to talk. Yeah, I know it. Yeah. We all have our challenges in life. Amen? But yet we all have answers. We all have answers. Amen? And that answer is to yield. Is to come and yield to God's love for you. Amen? Oh my God. Verse number 4 again. Nicodemus said unto him, how can a man be born when he's old? Can he enter a second time to his mother's womb and be born? Can he enter a second time to his mother's womb and be born? See, he's looking at it from a natural standpoint. From a natural standpoint, from a physical standpoint. Amen. Excuse me. But notice what God said in verse number 5. Jesus asked, verily, verily, I say unto thee, this is what he said now, except a man be born what? Of the water and of the Spirit, he cannot enter into the kingdom of God. You see, you think you can go into the kingdom of God, living a fleshly life, you won't make it. You won't make it. Except you be born again, you will not enter to the kingdom of God. Amen. you see, and then it goes on to say, right in verse number 6, that which is born of the flesh is flesh. That which is born of the spirit is spirit. Amen. Mama, not that I said unto you that you must be born again. The wind blow where it listen, you hear the sound thereof, but you cannot tell which is coming nor which it goeth. So is everyone that is born of the spirit. If you're born of the spirit, you will find yourself. You're talking about being translated. Okay. Amen. I don't know if God want to translate you, but I'm going to tell you something. It'll be just like you're translated from darkness to light. Amen. Your whole life will become something that God can take and apply. You know, when you're going through challenges, right now in this hour that we're living in, when you're going through challenges, it's just like the devil is trying to torment your mind to keep you out of the will of God. Trying to keep you from following the plan of God. Trying to keep you from following the purpose of God. Because if he can keep you from following God's plan and God's purpose by keeping you, making you think that you can never stop what you're doing, making you think that there's no way out, amen, then he can stop the will of God from happening in other people's lives around you. Why? Because, see, if you don't trust that God is using you, then you're not going to trust that God can deliver people through you. Y'all understand what I just said?
Yeah.
Because if you don't think that God can use you because of you still having trouble, you still having issues, then you're gonna be neglected to try to witness to someone, to try to talk to someone. Why? Because the devil has got you so focused on your mistakes, on your shortcomings, that you're afraid to say something to someone else. You know, I was in the mall Friday. That was Thursday. That was Friday, wasn't it? I was in the mall Friday in Roseville. And I went into Jumbo Juice to buy me a something to drink. And after I paid for it, and all of a sudden this young man, he said, I said, you made this real quick. And he said, yes, I did. And I said, well, I said, appreciate that. And he said, I thank you. And he said, God bless you. And I said, do you know him? See, he opened up the door. I said, do you know him? He said, yeah, I go to a certain church. And I said, really? I said, that's my friend. He said, really? I said, yeah. And then I talked to the one that waited on me. And this person said that, I asked this person, do you know him? She said, I used to know him. I said, you go to church? She said, I used to. I don't go no more. Then I talked to another one. Mm-hmm. She said, I quit going because my family was Mormons. So I quit going with them. I said, do you go to church anywhere right now? She said, no. And then I did. And then I said, and I said, are y'all ready to get your heart right with God? They said, yeah. And I said, put your hand right here in my hand. They laid the hand in my hand. Then another one in the back saw what was going on. She ran out and put her hand in my hand. And when I led all three of these persons to the Lord Jesus Christ. And boy, and when I did that, they said, wow, I feel that. Okay. I feel that. I feel that power. Amen. See, when you are not afraid to talk, when you're not afraid and you don't allow the devil to call you to walk in condemnation, you can be the light to someone that is in darkness. These young people gave their hearts to the Lord. And they were so excited about it. Everywhere I go lately, I've been leading people to the Lord because that's what's in my spirit, because of this message that I'm preaching. Amen. And let me tell you something. God is asking us to look at ourselves. He's asking us to look at ourselves. Remember what he said right here, verse number 3. And Jesus answered and said unto him, Verily, verily, I say unto you, except a man be born again. Except a man be born again. He cannot what? Except a man be born again. He cannot see the kingdom of God. He cannot see the kingdom of God. In verse number 5, verily Jesus said, Jesus answered, verily, verily, I say unto thee, except a man be born again, he cannot enter the kingdom of God. Remember verse number 3 said, you can't see me. Verse number 5 said, you can't enter. Amen. Amen. You can't enter. Then said verse number 6, that which is born of the flesh is of the flesh. That which is born of the spirit is of the spirit. Amen. Glory to God. And I like that because God is showing me something. Now notice what it said in verse number 9. Nicodemus answered and said unto him, how can these things be? Jesus answered and said unto him, art thou a master of Israel and knowest not these things? Verily, verily, I say unto thee, we speak that we know and testify that which we have seen. And ye receive not our witness. If I have told you what? Earthly things. If I told you earthly things and ye believe not, how shall ye believe if I tell you heavenly things? See, this is the problem. People, they want to hear something, but if you tell them something of the natural, they won't hear you. Then how do you expect them to understand you when you talk to them about spiritual things? That's why we have to be led by the Spirit of God. That which is born of the flesh can only speak of the fleshly things. And that which is born of the Spirit can speak of the things of the Spirit. Why? Because you have seen. You have entered. Remember what he said in verse number 3? Except you be born again, you will not see the kingdom of God. And then in verse number 5, except you be born again, you cannot enter into the kingdom of God. When I enter into the kingdom of God, I have set myself in position to share that which I have come to know and understand. If I don't understand it, how can I share it? Amen. And there are people around me, they need to hear what I come to understand. Because their life is in this balanced scale of life. And they need to hear something that's going to bring them to a position to be free from the pain, from the suffering, from the things of the past. And you have the answer. You have the word of life. You have the ability to speak into their situation. And everything around them begin to change. Everything begin to change. Amen. Mm-hmm. So he said right here in John chapter 3, verse number 13 said, no man had ascended up to heaven, but he that came down from heaven, even the Son of Man which is in heaven. And as Moses lifted up the serpent in the wilderness, even so must the Son of Man be lifted up. We cannot save this world apart from Jesus. We cannot get people saved apart from Jesus. We cannot get people to turn away from their sin apart from Jesus. Amen. How do you know? Look right here what it said, verse number 16. For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever believeth in him should not perish, but have everlasting life. Everlasting life. Amen. Verse number 17. For God sent not his Son into the world to condemn the world, but that the world through him might be saved. God is not going to condemn you because you make a mistake. God is not going to condemn you because you was not able to continue. God is not going to throw you into hell because you stumbled and failed. Look at the prodigal son. He got up, he brushed himself off, and he made his own decision. Nobody make him to make the decision. He made his own decision. He said, I'm going to go back to my father, and I'm going to tell my father that I sinned against heaven and in thy sight, and I'm not worthy to be called your son. It was at this point when this young man came to realize that his life was nothing without God. His life was going to a pit of hell without God. He realized it in his own heart, and he began to acknowledge in his own heart. Remember, the confession came out of his own spirit. No one was there to tell. The pigs couldn't talk to him. He was down on his knees about to eat the husk that the swine eat. But then, as he was about to put it to his mouth, he come to his senses. He said, "Oh, my father, have all these hired servants and have food enough and then something to spare. And here I am, I am perishing with hunger." A lot of us are perishing right now with spiritual hunger because we are not coming to the house of the Lord where you can be fed, where you can be nurtured, where you can be strengthened, where you can be empowered to receive the strength to go on to the next day or to the next month or to the next year. We have an obligation as the church to be strong in the word so that we can be the light of the world like God called us. Amen. And I know it's not easy. God never said it was going to be easy. He just said, do it. He never told you it was going to be easy. He never told you that you will never be attacked. He never told you that the Satan was going to leave you alone. Even when Jesus, it wasn't Jesus being attacked every day. Even by the people that loved him, he was still attacked. He didn't have no one he could go to and say, "Hey, brother, will you please pray for me? I'm under such an attack." Even when they went to the garden. No, not when he was at the garden. It was at the garden when Jesus took Peter and James and John with him to the garden. He said, "I want you to watch with him and pray while I go yawn and pray." And what did they do? They could not pray. Why? Because the spirit of slumber came upon them. And this is what's happened to the church today. The spirit of slumber. Every time you start to pray, don't you start... You start trying to read the word of God, then all of a sudden you go to yawning. One verse. But long you sit there and watch TV, you're not yawning. Long you sit there playing with your computer, you're not yawning. But the moment you pick up the word of God and start to read the word or start trying to pray, And that's the same thing that happened to Peter, James, and John in the Garden of Gethsemane. When Jesus said, "You pray here while I go yonder and pray." Your spirit is willing, but your flesh is weak. That's why God is telling us to strengthen our spirit. We walk in the spirit, not in the flesh. We walk by the spirit and not by the flesh. Y'all understand what I'm saying to y'all today? Amen. Because God is showing us something here. He's showing us that if we're going to accomplish, want us to accomplish, then we have to understand we must be born again of the Spirit. Amen. For God so loved that He gave us what? He gave us His love. He gave us His strength. He gave us His ability. He gave us His anointing. He gave us His nature. Amen. God is not looking at how you live or what you live. He's looking at how you conduct yourself while you're living. The way you conduct yourself, someone else may see you and they want to judge you. But when God look at you, God said, I love you. You can make it. You can do it. Don't give up. Don't quit. You can do it. You can do it. But when people look at you, you call yourself a Christian, and you can't even quit smoking cigarettes. You are a Christian. You can't even, you know, they come with all kinds of things. Mm-hmm. Why? Because they are having issues themselves and don't want to focus on themselves, so they focus on someone else. God is calling us out, folks. God is calling us out. God is calling us out. God is giving us, and he's giving us an opportunity to do some things that's going to make a difference in the earth. Look at Luke chapter 8, chapter 3, verse number 8. Luke chapter 3, verse number 8. Amen. Luke chapter 3, verse number 8, and it says, here we go. Thank you, Lord. Luke chapter 3, verse number 8, it said, being there, bring forth therefore fruit worthy of repentance. And begin not to say within yourselves, we have Abraham to our father. For I say unto you, that God is able to do what? God is able of these stones to raise up children unto Abraham. And now also the axe is laid to the root of the tree. Every tree, therefore, which bringeth forth, that bringeth not forth good fruit is what? It's hewed down and cast into the fire. And the people ask him, saying, what shall we do then? He answered and said unto them, he that, verse number 11, Luke 3:11, he that had two coats, let him impart to him that had none. And he that had meat, let him do likewise. Then came also publicans to the baptism to be baptized, and said unto him, Master, what shall we do? And he said unto them, accept no more than that which is appointed you. And the soldiers likewise demanded of him, saying, what shall we do? And he said unto them, do violence to no man, neither accuse any falsely, and be content with your wages. Huh? Be content with your wages. Amen. Glory to God. See, we have to understand to remain full of God's Spirit, to remain full of God's glory, we cannot accuse, we cannot speak evil, we cannot judge, we cannot take, we cannot be, that's right, greedy, because he said be content. See, we have the ability to keep the anointing to flowing. But when we start judging, when we start being judgmental, we start to point our finger, we dampen our anointing because we have become judge. Y'all understand what I'm saying?
Amen.
Okay. Now, God don't want us to be judges. God wants us to be followers. And I know that you're going to stumble and you're going to fall, just like the prodigal son. He was raised up in his father's house, and he said, Father, give me the portion of good that falls to me. Why? Because I want to go and see what the world is like. So the father divided his substance between his two sons. And the younger son, a few days later, took all that God has given him and went out and lived a life contrary to the will of God. Did God discredit him? Did God throw him away? Did God judge him? No, he did not. What did God do? when the young man realized that he was in error, he came back to his right mindset, and he began to acknowledge, God, I made a mistake. I know that I did wrong. You see, even though we know the wages of sin is death, but the gift of God is eternal life, how do we cause this become a reality in our hearts? By repentance. By repentance. By repentance. In Acts chapter 3, verse number 19. Acts chapter 3 has a lot to say about repentance. Because the book of Acts has a lot to say about repentance. Amen. Verse number 19, what it says? Acts 3, verse number, there we go. It says, repent ye therefore, and be converted, that your sins may be what? Blotted out. Blotted out. That your sin may be blotted out when the time of refreshing shall come from the presence of the Lord. And I like verse number 20. And he shall send who? Jesus Christ, which before was preached unto you. Are you ready to experience Jesus? Then you're going to have to experience repentance. You're going to have to experience repentance. Except the man be born again of the water and of the Spirit, he cannot enter into the kingdom of God. Amen. Cannot enter the kingdom of God. Amen. Glory to God. What then is the connection between repentance and salvation? What is the connection between repentance and salvation? Amen. So let's look at some more scripture. Let me show you something. Let me just show you. Because we are in a good place, right? Look at the book of Acts chapter 2, verse number 38. Acts chapter 2, verse number 38. Are y'all still with me? Acts chapter 2, verse number 38. Then Peter said unto them, repent and be baptized, every one of you, in the name of Jesus Christ, for the what? For the remission of sin. And ye shall receive the gift of Holy Spirit. The gift of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Verse number 30. Verse number 39. For the promise is unto you and unto your children and to all that are afar off, even as many as the Lord our God shall call. Hallelujah. Amen. Y'all understand what I'm saying? Amen. Now let's look at Acts chapter 11, verse number 18. Acts chapter 11. I'm just showing y'all, the book of Acts is full of people coming to know Christ. It's full of repentance. Talking about, it's so full of repentance. Acts chapter what? 11, verse number 18. And it says, when they heard these things, they did what? They held their peace. When they heard anything, they held their peace and glorified God, saying, then had God also to the Gentiles granted repentance unto life. Amen. See, we all have to come this route. This was not something that just started. This is something that God has been doing, has been dealing with since he established humanity. Since Adam fell in the Garden of Eden, God has been trying to get a way to the heart of the people that they can come back into right relationship with him. And right now, friend, that is through repentance. That is through acknowledging Jesus Christ as our Lord and Savior. And now, but you said, Pastor, you know, you just said that we all have sinned. Yes, we all have sinned. But there's a penalty for our sin unless we repent of our sin. Y'all understand what I'm saying? Yes. There's a penalty unless we repent of our sin. Amen? And that's why I'm showing you all these scriptures. Look at Acts chapter 17 and verse number 30. Acts 17. Come on, let's keep going. Acts 17 and verse number, oh God, this is scary. Let's start verse number 28. Because you see, we're not living in our own strength. We're living in His strength. Verse number 20 says, "For in Him we live and move and have our being." As certain also, of our own people have said, "For we are also His offspring. For as much then as we are the offspring of God, we ought not to think that the Godhead is like unto gold or silver or stone, graved by art and man's device." Verse number 30. "And the time of His ignorance, God did what? Winked at." He winked at. Verse number 30. Amen. "But now commanded" what? "All men everywhere to repent." God is commanding men everywhere to repent. That means that, you know, you want to live an alternate lifestyle, that, you know, God, you won't have no place in heaven if you do. The scripture tells us, I can show you in the Word of God. God created you to live a life separated from this world. He created all of us to do that. Now, we have to come to understand that unless we separate ourselves, we're going to continue to be pulled back, or we're going to constantly have a part in this old life that we once lived. Now, a lot of us still have issues back there, because we still sometimes, you know, we kind of look back and trying to figure out, well, how did this happen? Why did this happen? And just like my wife told me last night, that generational curse of your forefathers is still plays a part in your life. Amen? That generational curse of our forefathers still plays a part in our lives. Amen. God is showing us that we can have everything that we need in this life, but we have to get through Christ. Have to get it through Christ. Through Christ. Not by the will of the flesh, not by the will of man, but by the will of God. By the will of God. Am I making any sense today?
Amen. Yeah.
Because God is showing us something here. He's showing us something. Now look at Acts chapter 20. Acts chapter 26. Mm-hmm. Acts chapter 20, verse 21, I mean. Let's read verse number 19 through 21. You see, you might say, well, this don't apply to me. Yes, it does. Serving the Lord with all what? Humility of mind, and had many tears and temptations, many trials and temptations, amen, which befell me by the lying in wait of the Jews, verse number 20, how I kept back nothing that was profitable unto you, but have shown you and have taught you publicly and from house to house. Verse 21. verse 21, testifying both of the Jews, testifying both to the Jews and also to the Greek. Get this, he said now, repentance toward God and faith toward our Lord Jesus Christ. See, Paul and the apostles, everywhere they went, they preached repentance. They preached repentance, amen, and they focused on the people back to the Lord, not to themselves. We see this, see, the book of Acts is where we should be getting our meat, our strength, because we see the examples of men and women just like you and me. Carrying out the assignment. Amen. Notice what he says here. Because you see, verse number 21 again. Testifying both of the Jews, testifying both to the Jews and to also to the Greek. Repentance toward God and faith toward our Lord Jesus Christ. And now behold, I go bound in the spirit unto Jerusalem, not knowing the thing that shall befall me there. When you're walking with God, when you're doing the thing that God called you to do, you're not going to, you don't have no, how can I say this? You don't know the thing that you're going to come up against. You don't know the thing that's going to come against you. You just know that you are on a course that you got to walk. And the enemy is going to do everything he can in the process of you walking your course to try to interfere, to try to stop you by putting different thoughts in your head, in your mind. It's going to make you look at things you shouldn't be. It's going to want you to look at things you shouldn't be looking at. Make you want to say things you shouldn't be saying. Amen. Why? Because he wants to interfere with your destiny and with the destiny of those whom you've been sent to. Am I making the thing clear? Amen. Because this is what we see right here. This is what God is showing us right here. Amen. Now let's look at another scripture here in Acts chapter 26. Acts chapter 26. Acts chapter 26. Amen. Glory to God. Acts chapter 26.
26.
We're going to start verse number 16. And we're going to go down through 20. But rise and stand upon thy feet, for I have appeared unto thee for this purpose, to make thee a what? A minister and a witness. You see what God is saying? He have made you a minister and a witness of the things that God taught us through our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. But notice what he says right here. Let me just focus on this right here. But rise and stand upon thy feet, for I have appeared unto thee for this purpose, to make thee a minister and a witness both of these things which thou hast seen and of those things which thou hast, which I will appear unto thee. Amen. And you might say, well, Pastor, I'm not a minister. That's your job. He's not talking to me. He's talking to you alone. No, if you are born again, child of God, you are all ministers. You are ministers of the gospel. Amen. You are ministers of the gospel. Amen. So now notice what he said right here, verse number 17. He said, delivering thee from the people and from the Gentiles unto whom now I send thee, to open their eyes and to turn them from what? Darkness to light. And from the power of what?
Satan.
Of Satan unto God. Woo!
Exposed darkness.
My God. See, this is what God is looking for. He's looking for men and women who are not afraid, not ashamed, not talking about, you know, when you want to talk about God, say, we don't want to offend no one. We want to keep it low, you know. We don't want to talk about God too much because, you know, they might get offended. You know what happened when Daniel had this same challenge that we are faced with today? Yeah. King Darius. You know what happened to him? Daniel stood and he knew that the writing had been signed by the king that no one should pray to no one other than to the king. And Daniel, when he found out that it was signed, what did he do? He went into his chamber, he opened up his window toward the east, and he kneeled down and he began to pray. Knowing that they was looking to catch him in the act. And they knew the only way they could stop Daniel from ruling over them was to find something against him and his God, because the king had found favor in Daniel's heart because he had a perfect spirit in him. How did he get a perfect spirit in him? Because of his prayer life. Because of his life in the presence of God. And this is what God is saying to you and me. If we want to live a perfect life, then we gotta start praying like we never prayed before. We got to start believing God like we never believed before. We got to start walking with God like we've never walked before. Oh, shalalabakia. Amen. So we see here in Acts chapter 26. In Acts chapter what? 26 and verse number 17. He said, delivering thee from the people and from the Gentiles whom now I send thee. You know, when you're sent to people, they're going to try to do everything they can to cause you to fall. And the devil's going to put people in your path that's going to appeal to you very good. Why? So he can find something to accuse you. Something to cause you to become... something that will cause the people not to want to hear you. So he's going to put something in your path that's going to cause you, he's going to try to tarnish your presence in the eyes of men. And a lot of times it works. Why? Because the people are not understanding that God is trying to do something through that man, and therefore the enemy is trying to do everything he can to discredit that man or that woman. Amen. Verse number 18 says, to open their eyes and to turn them from darkness to light and from the power of Satan unto God, that they may receive forgiveness of sin and inherit among them which are sanctified by faith that is in me. Verse number 19, whereupon, O King Agrippa, I was not disobedient unto the heavenly vision, but showed first unto them of Damascus and at Jerusalem and throughout all the coast of Judea, and then to the Gentiles, that they should what? Repent and turn to God and do the works meet for repentance. Hallelujah. Woo! God is talking to us today. Amen. He's talking to us today. Why? Because we are in a time that the church people are in church but still living sinful lives. In church and still living sinful lives. And God's saying the wages of sin is death. I don't care if you are in church. It's still the same. The word of God not going to lose its strength just because you said, well, you know what? I heard the good word today. But what did he talk about? Oh, I forgot, but it was good. See, you're in church, you're not paying attention to what's going on. You're in church, you're not hearing what the Spirit of God is saying. So you don't know, you can't answer the question when someone asks you, what did the preacher talk about today? And what did it, and how do you apply that to your life? How can you apply to your life what he talked about today? Can you apply to your life? Do you want to apply to your life? Are you ready to give up all the things that you enjoy doing? Are you ready to lay down your life? Are you ready to be like Paul said, I'm crucified with Christ, nevertheless I live. Yet not I, but Christ liveth in me. And the life which I now live in the flesh, I live by the faith of the Son of God, who loved me, who gave himself for me. Therefore I lay my life down, and I will walk the life that he called me to walk. How many of you are ready to say, Lord, I choose to crucify my flesh. I choose to lay down everything that I am. You raising your hand?
Yes, I'm ready.
You ready?
I'm ready.
You ready?
Yes.
How many other people are ready? Amen. See, we can say we're ready, but when it actually comes to, when it boils down to the point that we're going to do what we say we're ready for, that's when we come up to the challenge. That's when we begin to face the challenge. I'm glad you said you're ready. I'm glad you said you're ready. But ready is not good enough. It's the doing. James 1:22. Be not a forgetful hearer of the word, but be ye doers of the word. God is looking for people that will allow his word to become a living reality in their hearts. Remember, that which is born of the flesh is flesh, and that which is born of the spirit is spirit. Jesus said, verily, verily, I say to you, except a man be born again, he will not see the kingdom of God. Verse number 3, John 3:3. Verse number 5 says, except a man be born again, he will not enter into the kingdom of God. God has given us our answers. God has given us our tools. He's given us a way out of our situation that we are in. Amen. To repent concerning salvation is to change our mind regarding sin and Jesus Christ. In Peter's sermon on the day of Pentecost in Acts chapter 2, he concluded with a call for all people to repent in Acts 2:38. Can we just look at that? Because God is calling us all to repentance. Verse number 38. We hit it earlier today. Well, let's do it again. Then Peter said unto them, repent and be baptized, every one of you, in the name of Jesus Christ for the remission of sin. And ye shall receive the gift of the Holy Ghost. You know, how many of you want to be baptized again? If you ever been, how many have never been baptized? Everybody been baptized? In water?
In water. Immersed.
Immersed?
Yeah.
How about you, sir? Because I'm ready to take y'all to the river. I'm ready to take y'all to the river and dunk you again. Amen. Because I don't have a pool to put you in. But that's a river down there. Amen. In Peter's sermon on the day of Pentecost, he concluded with the call to the people to repent. Repent from what? Peter called the people he called the people who rejected Jesus to repent. Look what it said, verse number 20, number 36. We just read 30. Let's back up to verse number 36. He said, therefore let all the house of Israel know assuredly that God had made that same Jesus whom ye have crucified both Lord and Christ.
He is the ruler.
Oh, I'm telling you, God is talking to us today. He's speaking to our hearts. And he's giving us the answer to our questions concerning our life issues. And that answer is that if we would judge ourselves, then we would not be judged. Amen. We must judge ourselves. And that what he says in the book of 1 Corinthians chapter 11. If we would judge ourselves, then we would not be judged with the world. Because the world is walking in darkness. And the judgment is coming upon the world like never before. You see, just on the 24th of this month, there was over 100 earthquakes right here in California. Just on the 24th of this month. Over 100 earthquakes. But then they said, no need to be alarmed. Because it was only a 3.4 average. I want to tell you, you better be alarmed. Because if those magnetic plates slip one way or the other the wrong way, California is gone into the ocean. But God is not just giving us a warning concerning the land. God's giving us a warning concerning our soul. And he's asking us to judge ourselves. He's asking us to examine our hearts. He's asking us to examine our motives. Why we do what we do. Is it of compulsion? Are you, my wife likes to say, addicted? But she's a substance abuse counselor. I can understand where she's coming from. Amen. Everything with her has got to do with addictions. Okay. I understand that. And God has given us a way to understand that his way is the right way. He said, I am the way, the truth, and the life. No man come to the Father but by me. God has warned us all to pay attention to everything we're doing in these last days. To be caught outside of God's grace in these last days is not good for any of us. That's why this message is so important. We must examine our hearts. We must repent. We must acknowledge Jesus Christ as our Lord and Savior. We must turn away from our sin. Father, I have delivered that which you have placed upon my heart for today. And I know, Father, that it's not a very popular message, but Lord God, this is what John the Baptist preached when he coming out and when he went out into the wilderness. And this is what Jesus preached when he come out from being tempted of the devil in the wilderness. And God, this is what the disciples began to teach. And they began to be crucified, killed, and ridiculed for the message that they carry on after you, Lord. And it's still the same today. So, Father, we look to you for comfort. We look to you for strength. We look to you to lead us and to guide us. We look to you, Father, to give us the ability to declare what you've given us to declare, regardless of how people look upon us, regardless of what people are saying about us. Father, help us to continue to carry out the assignment that you've given us. For we realize, we know that the wage of sin is death, but we also know that the gift of God is eternal life through Jesus Christ our Lord. As by one man sin into this world, so death by sin, so death passed upon all, for all have sinned. There's no holy man, there's no righteous man, so holy, so righteous, that he's not committed something in his life that he need not to repent of. Every man in this earth today, Father, every woman in this earth today has a reason to repent for whatever they're doing. And yet they look at themselves like they don't do nothing, but they want to judge everyone else. Father, I ask you to forgive them that they want to pass judgment on people that are not looking at their own lives. I ask you to forgive them. Then, Father, give them the grace to love, to honor. And then, Father, let the spirit of forgiveness rest upon the entire body. For we all have sinned and come short of your glory. Jesus, you are the answer. You said in John chapter 3 verse, you said that you are the way, the truth, and the life, that no man come to the Father but by you. So, Father, we come. John 14. We come. Our hearts have been so troubled, but yet we come. Because you said, let not your heart be troubled. So we're cleaving to your word, God, like never before. And I release a blessing over your people. I counsel in the spirit every demonic assignment that would try to interfere with their lives, with their walk, with their purpose and their plan that you have ordained for their lives. I take a stand in the spiritual realm against it right now in the name of Jesus. And I declare and decree, Father, today marks the day that we will focus on that which you have made known to our hearts today, that we will not look on the things which are seen and think this to be permanent, but we look on those things which are not seen, because the things that are not seen are eternal. We give you all the praise and all the glory for what you're doing right now, Father, in our hearts and in our lives. Bring us to the place, Father, to examine our own hearts. That we will like look at our own life. That we will not look at anyone else's life, but we'll look at our own life. And we'll not point our fingers and say, you're going to hell. No, we're going to say, God, you the judge. We're not going to point our finger. We're going to leave the judgment. We're going to leave the judgment to you, Lord God. And we're going to point our finger, we're going to point in love, saying, come, Jesus said, I am the way, the truth, and the life. No man come to the Father but by me. We're going to not just point our finger, we're going to reach our hand. We're going to pick them up. We're going to pull them up out of that muck and mire clay. We're going to help them to get back on the right track, on the right path. And your name will be glorified, Father, because we did it your way. In Jesus' name. Jesus' name. Amen. 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 Thank you, Father. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Father. I bless you. I bless you, Father. I bless you. Father, there are those that are watching by the internet right now. And God, their lives is in shambles. And they're looking for ways out, Lord God. And I'm asking, Father, that you would touch their lives. That you would touch their hearts. And that you would bring them to the place of repentance. That their hearts can turn toward you. I thank you for it in Jesus' name. Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. Glory to God. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Y'all get anything out of this day? It was totally, because I keep telling God, I said, God, I don't know what else to say about this message that you got me preaching. And every Sunday when I get up and pulpit, he always give me another avenue to go. And I said, Lord, thank you. Because I didn't know what I was going to talk about today. I knew I had to talk about it, but I didn't know which direction I was going to come from. And God gave me a different avenue to help us to understand the importance of repentance. Sin separates us from God. And y'all tired? Y'all don't want to be separated no more? Then repent. Repent. That's all it is. That's what he's asking you to do. Repent. That's what he's asking all of us to do. Amen. It's time for us to prepare our offering for today. Amen. Those of you that are with us by the internet, you want to sow a seed today, you can go to my website. Amen. And you can plant your seed and know that God is with you. Amen. And don't forget, we're still preparing ourselves for Pakistan. Amen. In October, we are asking that you support this, if the Lord leads on your heart to do so, to sow a seed, amen, to help us to meet the budget. And they were wanting me to come in July, but my budget is not ready yet, not even halfway there yet, amen. So I said I can't make it in July. But we are back on schedule for October. And if the budget's not ready for October, we're going to push it off a little bit further. Amen. But we're not going to push it off indefinitely. But we are going to go and accomplish. We're going to do what God called us to do. Because I believe that God is going to provide for this work. Because this is not the work of a man. This is the work of God. Amen. And I believe God will provide for this work. So, and God uses people. God uses people. And if God did with your heart to sow a significant seed, then do so as God had placed upon your heart. Amen. You can go to my website, LandbergerMinistry.com. Amen. Or you can send it through the postal service. That's P.O. Box 41, 7913, Sacramento, California, 95841. Amen. Or you can use your Cash App. Amen. And you can also use Venmo, V-E-M-O, amen. You can also use Venmo, and you can also use PayPal, amen. Father, in the name of Jesus, I pray for everyone that you're touching their hearts, God. Father, you know those that you have used to help us in time past. Father, they know what we're doing. They know we're not doing it to be seen of man, but doing it for the souls, amen, to be delivered from the powers of darkness. I pray, Father, that you will even touch their hearts, that they will sow again, Father, in the name of Jesus. And Lord, whatever you do, do it to your glory. And then, Father, as people release that seed, Father, I'm asking you in the name of Jesus that supernaturally they will begin to experience financial increase, money coming from unknown sources. Immediately, Father, I release that upon them now in Jesus' name. As they sow their seed, Father, within a day or so, they're going to get a touch on their finances. They're going to let them know it is because of the seed that they've sown. Father, I thank you for it right now in Jesus' name. I thank you for it right now in Jesus' name. The reason why I say it like that, because I sowed a seed the other day into the Mercy Chef, the people that goes out into the hurricanes and have to feed the families and help them and everything. I sowed a seed into that the other day. And 2 days later, 2 to 3 days later, this just happened. I got a $300-some from a source I didn't even expect. And I believe God wants to do the same thing for you. You sow that seed in faith and let God bring it in the way he wants to. Don't look to man. Just look to God. Amen. Father, I bless the seed that you're sowing today, that we're sowing today. I bless the people that are sowing today, Father. And I ask you, Father, in the name of Jesus, that you will cause that seed to multiply and come back into their lives very soon. I call it in now in Jesus' name that they will not miss it, Lord God, but they'll see the effect of their giving. And your name will be glorified, Father, because they chose to put your word to the test. And you proved your word. And you answered with increase. In Jesus' name, I thank you for it. Amen. If you're here today, you never made Jesus Christ the Lord of your life, I'm going to give you the opportunity to do that now. If you never made Jesus Christ the Lord of your life, I'm going to give you the opportunity to do that now. Amen. Because God loves you, and he wants to do something right now in your heart. You heard this message today talking about repentance. Amen. How sin separates you from the presence of God. And now you want to get your heart right with God so that you will not be one that is separated from God, but that you will walk, but you are walking with God. You want that to happen for you today? Then say this prayer with me. Ask Jesus Christ to forgive your sin and come into your heart to be your Lord and Savior. Amen. And God will cause you to begin to experience the new life that he created you to walk in. Say this prayer with me. Say, Lord Jesus.
Lord Jesus.
I repent of my sin.
I repent of my sin.
Forgive me, Lord.
Forgive me, Lord.
Come into my heart.
Come into my heart.
Create in me.
Create in me.
A right spirit.
A right spirit.
And renew in me.
And renew in me.
A clean heart.
A clean heart.
Jesus, I believe.
Jesus, I believe.
That you are the Son of God.
That you are the Son of God.
And that you died for my sin.
And you died for my sin.
Today, as I confess.
Today, as I confess.
My sin.
My sin.
I accept you.
Accept you
as my Lord and Savior.
As my Lord and Savior.
Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Jesus.
For saving me.
For saving me.
Amen. Amen. If you said that prayer right now, I believe that God's hand is resting upon you to deliver you, to set you free, so that you can experience the abundant life that Jesus Christ came to introduce you to live. God bless you. Amen. We believe that God is working on your behalf. Amen. Father, I pray for all those that said that prayer, that said it from their hearts and meant what they said. And I ask you, Father, in the name of Jesus, that you will show yourself strong on their behalf, that you would visit them, Father, that you will minister to their hearts and help them to understand what just took place in their lives, in their hearts, that they are no longer a child of the darkness, but they are a child of the Most High God. And they are walking in the light of your word. Help them to understand that, Father. I thank you for it in Jesus' name. Then send them to a place, Father, where they can learn more of what just took place in their hearts and in their lives. And I give you all the glory for it in advance. Amen, amen, amen. If you're here today, you need special prayer, I pray for you right now. Thank you, Lord. Hello, sister. Father, in the name of Jesus, I speak to the lungs and I release the power of God. In the name of Jesus Christ, I speak to the lungs. Be healed in Jesus' name. Be healed in Jesus' name. Father, I give you praise. I give you glory. I give you praise. I give you glory. Lungs, be healed in Jesus' name. Thank you, Father. Take a deep breath now. Now breathe out. There you go. There you go. That's it. That's it. That's it. That's it. In the name of Jesus, there you go. You heal it. Receive it. There it is. Receive it. Receive it. Receive it. Jesus' name. Jesus' name. Amen. Thank you. Thank you, Lord. Anyone else need prayer right now? Come on, sir. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Father, in the name of Jesus, I pray, Father, for my brother's daughter. In the name of Jesus, Lord God, I ask you, Father, that you would touch her. God, that you would cause her heart to turn toward you. God, that you would not only turn her heart toward Father, but you forgive her of sins. God, that you would give her the heart to come into your house to worship you and to serve you. Then, Father, I'm asking you right now for a miracle in her health. A miracle in her health, in her joints, Lord God. Father, in the name of Jesus, I ask you, Father, that you restore the cartilages in her joints, in the name of Jesus. And Father, let this miracle be an eye-opening to her, that she will know that you are God, and that there's none like you, Father, that she will repent of her sin and give her heart to you. In Jesus' name, Father, I bless this brother, and I bless his family, and I give you all the praise and all the glory for what you're about to do, for what you're doing right now in this family. In Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. Now receive that. Receive that in Jesus' name. Glory to God. Thank you, Lord. 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 Praise you, Lord Jesus. It's done? All right. Glory to God. Glory to God. Glory to God. Father, in the name of Jesus, I pray for my brother. I pray for his daughters. Father, I pray that your hand continue to rest upon them. Lord, in the name of Jesus, let their eyes be opened that they may know what is the hope of your calling. Lord, they see the greatness of your power toward us who believe according to the workings of your mighty power. I break every demonic assignment and work against their minds, their wills, and their emotions. I plead the blood of Jesus over them right now in Jesus' name. Father, I cancel every spirit of witchcraft that is working. I cancel every spirit of deception that is trying to speak to their hearts. I loose it off them right now in Jesus' name. Lord, let the spirit of peace and truth rest upon them right now. And let your word, Father, manifest in their hearts like never before. And that they will know the truth. And that the truth will cause them to continue to walk in freedom. In Jesus' name, amen. Glory to God. Glory to God. Thank you, Lord. Now, Father, I pray for those that are with us by the internet. I pray, Father, that your hand continue to rest upon them, that you would move in a supernatural way, Father, upon every heart and every soul under the sound of my voice. Father, they may have children that are wayward children. They may have children, Lord God, that are going astray. And Father, I lift up their children before you right now. And I ask you, Father, in the name of Jesus, that you will breathe upon them, that you will cause them, you cause their hearts to be attentive to your word, and to the Spirit of God. And that, Father, that you deliver them and set them free. Bring them to a place, Father, where they will know you, that they will come to know you and turn their hearts toward you in repentance. I thank you for it now in Jesus' name. I bless your people. God bless you. We love you. Join us tonight as we come back at 6:30 to hear the word of the Lord. We love you. Until then, be blessed. God bless you.